Hello and welcome to our flight. I am Direct Uplink and I'll be your pilot today. We are currently in Rosh, Pina, right above the Sea of Galilee at the airport Lima Lima Indigo Bravo. And we are going to be headed south towards the Jerusalem airport and Lima Lima Juliet Romeo. So let's go ahead and get started. We're just at the taxiway right now, because there is no other place to be, since there's not a terminal on this one. Alright, we're going to do VFR, so we're just going to follow the Jordan right down to it. So we'll set the squawk as 1200, that's good. The comms are 122.8, since there's no ATC at the moment. Let's see. Okay, the navs are set. Set the altitude 7,000. The altimeter is 2965. Okay, that's good for where we're at. Alright, it's getting a little dark. We'll turn on the lights. Taxi, nav. Okay. All right, we'll set the air pressure for the cabin. Okay, so about 7,000. There we go. All right, everything else. Set this. I believe it's already set, but just activate it. Okay, and all right, let's go. So I'm already connected up to Vatsim as well. Good to be able to let them know who you are, of course. That always helps. It's partly cloudy here today, both in the sky and on land, because apparently I have some satellite imagery for our flight, but right here that's clouds on the imagery, so that's pretty awesome. Right, there's no one in the area. No ATC either, so we'll just go ahead. flaps down. It's a short runway. So that's right here. Sit up a little bit. There we go. Stop slouching. And here we go. Flaps up, gears up. Start heading towards our destination. We'll actually just autopilot do it. Okay. It's going pretty well. Right here is the Sea of Galilee. So where we're going right now is basically the trip that Mary took when she was pregnant with Jesus. She went to Bethlehem, which is just below Jerusalem, but there's no airport in Bethlehem, so, or at least not one that X-Plane has. Looks a little weird with the clouds there on the textures, but what are you gonna do? Tried using the Google and Bing, but those didn't work. Let's take a look outside. Looks pretty hilly. There's pretty much an incline the entire way there. So that was a rough walk. Should probably let people know. Let's see where we headed. I obviously need some work on that. To the left, there should be the Jordan River as well. So we're pretty much going to be following that the whole way. The Jordan River flows, or we're headed towards the Salt Sea. As it reloaded, you could kind of see it a little bit. See if you can see it up ahead. Yeah, because ultimately it's in between both of these mountains here. And it's just going the entire way. Yeah, that's it, right there. Yeah, when it's clear out, this satellite imagery is pretty good. Take another look outside. Oh yeah. Still an incline. We're flying with CanadianXpress. It's an excellent airline where they allow you to fly anywhere just to have a little bit more sense of realism, just to be associated with an airline. So we just have to use their exterior skin, which isn't bad. Show you. So, yeah, they're pretty good. You only need to make a flight every couple of months. So if you don't have a lot of time, but you still want to have a sense of that extra little bit of realism, then they're a good airline company to go with. So I know a lot of the other airlines, they require quite a bit, like 3 or 4 hour flights every month. I wish I could be able to do that, but yeah, I don't have that kind of time. This would be an amazing journey, though, to hike all of that. So let's see where we're at. Okay, so we got a little bit of ways to go yet. We're at 7,000 feet, so... Another glimpse as the... weather updates and the nice little clouds in the satellite imagery. At least you're getting to kind of get to see some of the cities. And we're flying in a Beechcraft 1900. It's very well done. Take a glance in the back since it's on autopilot anyway. Go a little bit faster. And this is what it would look like as you're if you're a passenger. Pretty cool. So you just have the lights or nothing. Ah, it does. Cool. Aren't clickable. That's okay. Alright, let's check out this side. Thankfully, there's not too many people in these seats. Kind of go wherever you want. Oh, except for I set the weight. Inside the plane for about 8 people, so. Started descent. Actually, let's go check out the Jordan. There it is. So we'll be landing on runway 30, so we need to go this way anyway. that might be the end of the satellite imagery. Perhaps either that or the start of a new one. All of a sudden it's cloudy. Nice. Okay, we'll head back. Oh, it is satellite imagery. Okay. Just a different day. Time of the year, I guess. I believe, these images are from Yahoo and MapQuest. They're basically about the same, so they must get it from the same source. Specks are just the trees. That's auto-populated. Salt Sea, very top of it. So that means just right over here will be Bethlehem. So it wouldn't be surprising that everyone would walk down alongside the Jordan River just because it's an easier path. You don't have to climb up mountains. Alright, and elevation at the Jerusalem airport is 2465. So we'll get down a little bit lower, slow down quite a bit. In pretty fast. Might need to go around again. See if you can see it yet. Is it right there? Nope. Be right over here somewhere. If only I'd zoom in eyes. Ah, there it is. Right there. Okay. So come around. See a little bit more of the salt sea. This is a really cool area. Right here. Stop it. Whoa. Whoa. Ah. There it is. That. not my best landing at all, but we have arrived at the Jerusalem airport in Lima, Lima, Juliet Romeo. Lovely mistake I made on the joystick, which is just disregard that. There's no terminal at this one, so we'll just stop here on the taxiway. There we go. Just tell them. All right, thank you for flying, and hope to see you again.